28-year-old hair transplant candidate. I've been losing my hair since 20 when I had a stressful time in a relationship and at university. Dyed and sleep suffered, and I had anxiety. In my teens, I did dye my hair black, and some hair fell out as a result. My hair is still progressively thinning. I keep it long on top to try and cover the visible scalp. It is causing me a lot of stress trying to compensate for the lack of hair, and I haven't been sleeping too well. Do I look like a suitable transplant candidate?
Thank you for your question. You're 28 years old. You submitted a couple of photos of the top of your scalp, which are very helpful. You describe a situation where you've been losing hair since the age of 20, and you describe different periods of your life where you've had a lot of stress. And unfortunately, the hair loss is adding to that stress. So the first question you're asking is, are you a suitable candidate for a hair transplant? Well, to give you a little bit of background about myself to help you understand this question, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon, and I've been performing hair transplant for over 20 years. I've been practicing in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and I can tell you that one of the most important things to understand about hair transplant is the limitation. You're 28 years old and you have very advanced hair loss. The thing about the hair transplant industry is that the expectations of results are very often not met because of a combination of overselling from aggressive marketing combined with the reality of the limitations of the donor area. If you think about it, the top of your head needs a certain number of hairs. And when you look at the back of the scalp, where the true permanent zone is, there simply is not enough hair. And if you think about your progression, where will you be a year from now, 2 years from now? We have seen many patients like yourself who tried to have transplant in their 20s to try to compensate for their hair loss. By the time they hit their mid-30s, they really look like they didn't have transplants. They look like they had still thinning hair. Now, many people have tried in your age range to use drugs like finasteride. Finasteride is an effective drug for patients whose hair are DHT sensitive. Finasteride is an oral medication. It's a drug that inhibits an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. This is an enzyme which inhibits a conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. The challenge is that many people don't respond because their hair follicles are not responsive to DHT. So therefore, clearly there's a lot of unknown to factors that are also contributing to hair loss. There have been numerous chromosomes associated with hair loss, approximately 11 of 23 pairs. So in our practice, we have been very excited to help patients like yourself with a non-surgical option called hair regeneration. Hair regeneration was a kind of an accidental discovery based on the observation that a wound healing material called acellular matrix, when used for hair transplant, appeared to make thinning hairs look thicker. So what we've done over several years is develop a system and process so that we actually do an injection as an alternative to transplantation that reverses hair thinning. Now, the challenge for us is when a patient comes. It's not like we can take a bald person and make them into a mop top. It's really how soon after your onset of hair loss and the rate of progression affect how well the treatment works. But it cannot be understated that the treatment has been close to 100% beneficial for male pattern hair loss. There are occasional patients who don't respond to the treatment, but that is a very small group. We have not yet been able to figure out how to predict that. But with odds where close to 100% of male pattern hair loss respond, it has been a huge success for patients who have come to us from all around the world. We have reached a point where we have been so successful with it that we're now scaling this this treatment to try to bring it closer to people. And the company we started is called TrichoStem Hair Regeneration. The point is that this is a treatment which so far has been essentially a one-time treatment, and in some patients after a year we'll do a second injection to build upon what we've done. And someone like yourself at your level, advanced hair loss, is typically someone who would probably get a second treatment. But again, with several years of data, 3 to 5 years of data, we have been able to show no significant regression with this treatment. Essentially, if this treatment is, and we will of course learn more as the time goes on, if a treatment is required once every 3 to 5 years to maintain and thicken your hair, from my experience, it far exceeds the benefits of a surgical transplantation, where if you were to have it done every 3 years, you'd run out of donor area and you haven't done anything for your existing hair. Now, sometimes we do combine this, but in general, especially for someone in their 20s, we try to avoid surgical hair transplantation. So I recommend you learn more about this option as well as continue doing research, but I would discourage you from having hair transplantation. I don't think that's the right solution for you. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.